Shrivatsa, what do you say? Do you feel the CIO is throwing the spanner in the works? Because there have been surveys that say that, you know, CIOs are pulling back when it comes to, you know, implementing, deploying mobility within an enterprise. What do you think, and what is the way ahead?
The most important is when it comes for mobility, or rather for any technical or transformation project, the CIO's role has to get transformed to a change agent. The moment when CIO realizes that beyond technology and beyond innovation is also a change agent, your half the battle is won. Like how I segmented the mobile strategy into the Salesforce automations, your mobile app rendering to the consumer. To start with the mobile lead management system, which we implemented for the Salesforce automation and tab-based account opening, you need to have a change control board and involve the stakeholders. You can't just build marvels of technology and expect that people will adopt it. Mm-hmm. And you can't expect that just because as a consumer, people are adopting apps into the mobile phones, when they come to the office space, they are completely different animal. Even for a desktop support, they expect that someone from the IT should come and help them. When they're at their home, they're on their own, right? So it's a change management that you need to manage. So you need to have a change control board in place, and you need to have a team beyond implementation. So how do you go about adopting mobility? So what we did from our side as a success story is, we had a team of 7 to 8 people. They are just simple executives who used to do MIS and analytics. And automated MIS analytics used to get published every 1 hour to 4 hours and 3 hours. It used to say what is the adoption of each feet on street, whether they're using the mobility or not. And if they were not using the mobility, there used to be a call going to those initially for the first 3 months. And there used to be a question to them saying that, are you having any technical problem? Are you not able to update? If there was a technical problem, you used to fix the problem. If there's no problem, then there used to be a pressure for update. So you need to have a carrot stick approach for adoption. And eventually you need to have a blend of even incentivizing them. Like few incentivizing is, we made their problem easy, right? They went, the feet on street went on to close the lead. They did not come to the branch. And what did we do? We said that don't worry about your the payouts that you get from the travel expenses. It's automated. You don't have to fill in. No more hassles of your approvals from your higher authorities. It's all auto-calculated and it's rendered to you.
Right.
So that's a kind of incentivization you give. And which feet on street want to come to an office? Most of them, they don't want. They're more than happy to meet 5 customers in the market today. You give them the tools and technology. You give them the required support. You handle their change management. It goes through. The other challenge about the consumer app, the expectation from the consumer is very high. We have limitations in terms of what we can render to them because irrespective of whatever marvels you create, it goes through an approval process like Kirsi rightly pointed out. And it needs to be approved by the exchange, both NSC, BSE. And then if there's some innovation, again, it needs to be approved by them. So there is some amount of restrictions keeping in mind on what information and rendering we can do to the consumer, because there's not enough of an information security layer that is built on mobility. The major challenge is today, if you ask me which is the right platform in which you can build your complete applications, which can render seamlessly all your mobile application across OS, I don't think so. That maturity level has come right now. It's still under experimentation.
Okay.
So you have a stage where you have platform. People come and claim that there is a platform available. Your app, once developed, can be rendered in all OS. But the cycle time for rendering in all OS is still high. It's not as seamless as what it's been stated in the industry. The second most important challenge is the expectation from the consumer is, beyond an app, how do I also interface with the backend team out there? Like, how do you get messaging layer into the mobility app, right? Because people are used to WhatsApp. People are finding WhatsApp so convenient. Within the organization, you have groups of teams of people. For each project, they create WhatsApp.
Right.
And they find that as a more convenient medium for them through mobility to converse with people. The conversation over emails have come down. The conversation over WhatsApp has gone up. Similarly, from a consumer perspective, they are more happy to have their customer interface through WhatsApp. They're expecting that if I put a request from WhatsApp, I want someone from XYZ company to respond back me through WhatsApp. So how do we bring about those kind of communication layer within your mobile app? So if he has some problem, how do we take a screen share of a mobile app and solve this problem? And how do we do analytics out of it? Not enough analytics has been done. People have rendered their mobiles, people have given it for service and transactions, people have integrated, we have integrated it with CRM. Who does an analysis to find out what is the profile of customers who have come in? What is the demographics of the customers who are using it? And hence, what is their expectations? How many of us are listening back to what customers are giving as a feedback in the query request complaint section of your mobile phones? Are you quick enough to go back to the customer, implement them, and inform them? Are you reading what is being put as in comments in your app stores? Now, these are the challenges which the industry needs to plug in.
Sure.
So people are more interested in building beautiful UI, UX and apps and rendering it. The post facto is what has been ignored right now. That is the maturity level the industry has to look upon it, because the innovation of next level comes from there.
Sure. So Mr. Shah, what are your thoughts? What do you feel are the challenges, and what do you think of the carrot and stick policy of
the industry? Pointed out, things are right. First is the mobile strategy at the top to the bottom level. So that is the adoption which is there. The CIO's role is no longer restricted to technology. It's restricted more with the business and alignment, because since business goes in the market, and I call it two way. You either innovate or you look at what others are doing and do it. But you'll be able to copy the UI, but the underlying infrastructure has to be robust enough to take care of the transactions.
Right.
The challenges which are really faced is, you may sit in an AC room and devise an app. I'm talking of internal customers, but you have to really go feet on street. So there was a project when we had launched this app, we were also skeptical whether the adoption would be there right from a rural folk to the... We had our mobile numbers at the CIO and the lower level that any associate can call up anybody to give his issues. And we have literally done internal surveys to ensure that the adoption is there. And in last 1.5 years, we have seen the adoption reaching to 85%, which is quite good in a scenario where the mobile network connectivity is not there and it's seamless is there. So this is one of the challenges. Second challenge is the infrastructure. Third is the demand is fine. You can't develop a typical software development lifecycle. So the expectation is that one app has been done, just ensure that a similar thing is done. But you have to have the robust infrastructure in place, do the integration layer at the light level. And third part would be the last would be the very security layer, which would have to be taken care of. So privacy laws are also coming into being.
Right.
India is also adapting to privacy laws. There are so many court cases going on. So you have to add up all this at the end customer, what data are you trying to share? And this is the key aspects which are the real challenges which are there. So the CIO has to be more with the business aligned and ensure the security layers are in place and the robust infrastructure.
And your thoughts on having a change management board in place?
Yeah, so like we also have a similar thing. As I told you, the digital strategy starts from the C to the bottom layer. So if you are aligned with the business on what is the expectation, everything has to go through the change control board.
Right.
So the strategy has to be in place, and then you have, we also have our own internal change control board, which meets quite often on what are the digital strategies which are put in place.
Sure. Sir, what are your thoughts on it?
So I'd like to react to that statement of yours where the CIO is perceived as a roadblock rather than an enabler, right? A couple of things have happened. I think one, with the tablet, that ceiling of the form factor and the ability to have a rich transaction has been broken. So now you have people attempting to do much more on a tablet, which essentially is still on a mobility space, and interact with the enterprise. However, in the back end, the amount of functionality that we were willing to put out on the website has to now effectively get translated into being put on the tablet. And I don't think our back-end infrastructures or the middlewares are yet in that ready for that kind of transformation. So which essentially means large investments or going ahead and saying this is something that I'll only do in terms of elapsed time 6 months later. And that's one of the reasons where we are perceived as being roadblocks, right?
Right, because obviously capital is hard to come by.
The second is in terms of the actual demands. These demands are arising out of the marketplace. We in financial services have to be really alert as compared to maybe a manufacturing to what the marketplace is, and business models are changing.
Right.
Today you have Kapil Sharma urging everybody to buy insurance through an aggregator portal.
Right.
Today you have a lot of customers going ahead and interacting a lot more on Facebook, etc. So lead generation is changing.
Absolutely.
And now each one of these has to translate into some kind of a business scenario and effectively harvested into customers. Now, I am not too sure that we even have the ability in our existing systems to be able to cater to these. So, as an IT person, one tends to take a cautious call and say, okay, if this is what you want me to be ready for, then probably it will take me 6 more months, 3 more months, and then there's always the, if you look at some of the presentations that are made by some of the vendors that come and talk to our businesses, they promise the moon in a day's time. So that's another reason where, oh, look at our IT department. That's such a disappointment to hear 3 months when somebody from the vendor side is saying it's possible in a day.
Right. Absolutely.
So I think those are two of the things that I see as reasons why CIOs are seen as roadblocks. Right.
What are your thoughts, sir? And what challenges do you feel?
I have a different perspective. That's okay. What, because for us, customer himself not aware of the information. So mm-hmm. we have to see the pros and cons. For us, like customer, you might be looking for an astrological message. Being in Kanya Star, you'll get a money back. Either in an IVR or in a multilingual, will delight him more than even printing a receipt. And generally, and as an average, we rate rural customers more brilliant than the metro customers. Because they preserve all the receipts, they do go through all the options, they do go through every each and point, and they confirm to us like this is right, this is what it is. And better thing is what, like if you see comparatively from last 2-3 years, we use GeoSpatial to get that best in terms of identifying the customer locations with latitude, longitude, which was not there available earlier. But if you see from the customer angle, which we are able to connect customer to customer, and customer to customer with their product lines, and customer to customer with their expectations in terms of even a guy who was farmer, who has to take that load towards their customer, again, he's a transporter. So all those things, we are able to do it today, and we are able to serve back to them. So customer-wise, they are able to expect a lot from them. And compliance-wise, earlier, we don't have any validation, either a ration card, whatever you call it out, everything is a bogus in the rural India. So today, at least the latitude, longitude, we are able to create and we are able to depend on the information. Second is what, like if you see from the mobile perspective, even though that maturity comes up more in the metro side, still rural has its own impact, where right. their expectations are too high. Like they say, even don't call me after 6. And okay. don't call me before 6 in the early morning. So these are the restrictions, privacy. Mm-hmm. They are in a different world. Right. So if you're able to game that properly and bring it out, these are the pros which we can go back to them. And customers so far, they're able to even demand saying, like, can I get an astrological printout in a long term? So those are the informations which we got from the customers. And from the back end, what we see is what, like, since mobile comes out where people used to take photo on photographs. So what had happened, majority of the photographs come back to the system which they will mark to IT, saying like since you said why CIOs are taking the back seat, we have to sit with the auditors to convince them to say like why this has come, how to avoid that. So then we suggested our executives can stand next to the customer and take a photograph. Majority of the photograph, we won't know who is customer, who is our executive. So these are the combinations of challenges when you go in rural India, we try to bring it out on mobilization. Right. But overall perspective, we see in last 18 years, the day one, what we saw and today, what we see, at least we are able to dictate a customer sitting here, dictate an executive who can get even his incentive or convince within the same day. Uh-huh. Earlier, even an executive will get his convince after 6 months. If you see in banking industry, frauds tend to happen when customer money is carrying and he is not getting his incentive on time. Majority of the people are outsourced and they are trying to do with us. If he is getting his money on the same day, he is ready to settle that whatever he is collecting. But generally we do all validation for him and our money we want him to settle on the same day. So right. this actually got enabled through mobile and we okay. all the people they are able to do and we are able to service more on that. So pros and cons are there, but mobility has enabled whatever problems we do have, we are able to connect to them. Like address was a problem. Longitude, latitude can get to the next level. Photograph was a problem. Now at least we are able to go to the next level. So some of the areas which has taken to the next level, which sure. mobility can play a different role on that.
Sure.
Otherwise, challenge continues.
Right. Sure.